Hello and welcome to the channel. It's Rob here. Thanks for tuning in. If you guys are new here, this is actually a first for me too. I've kind of got a new setup. I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. I'm working on a brand new show, and I just purchased a few things that I will be unboxing in order to do that new show. So that's what's going on here.
Channel, it's Rob here.
Oh man, I'm getting talkback.
This is actually a first for me.
Oh, okay.
Either.
You probably have something open in one of yours.
I'm gonna be doing something a little bit different.
For
authors,
that's not muted.
So
you'd be
a
periscope open.
Oh yeah, look at that. Okay, so I should close that.
Open your periscope.
Unboxing. In order to do that new show, so that's what's going on here.
Yeah, that's
oh,
it right
is
here.
It. Okay, yeah. So
how do I just
or
X
just go onto your just go onto your.
Just, oh, there I go. I'm just muting it. Oh, okay, cool. All
right, so this is brand new. Hey, what's up? What's up? Hey, I'm doing well, Kat. Thank you.
That might make it lag, though, to have that open.
Oh, to have that open
yeah.
Might make it lag. Okay, cool. This is brand new. This is the first time I'm going to be...
What's up, bro?
I'm doing
okay, you're
this.
Getting comments from people on YouTube.
Oh, hey. Whoa, from YouTube. What's
yep.
going on, Jimmy? This is really cool. Awesome. Well, thank you for tuning in. Hold on. Let me put some music on real quick. Can you guys hear that music? Oh, this is some good stuff. Hey, what's up, Rob? Oh my god, another guy on YouTube. You rock. UK Beard Appreciation Society. What's up, Bruce? Oh my gosh, you guys rock. This is cool. Can you guys all see each other's messages? That would be badass if we can just all talk on the same, like, different platforms in the same space. Yeah, thank you, Kat. Yeah, I'm feeling a lot better. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, I feel so much better. Like, so much better. It's actually been a ridiculous night and day change for me these past few days. I'm actually eating multiple meals a day, which is like, what's up? Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you, Mystique. Hey, what's going on? Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you, Jimmy. Yeah, slowly but surely building the YouTube channel. I'm excited about it. I've got a lot of really cool ideas for the YouTube channel as this year progresses. But I had this is going to be like the first of like a hopefully a series of videos I do where I'm kind of in more of a studio setting, and I'm performing more just for you guys here on stream instead of at a show and also for you guys. Hey, what's up, Holland? How you doing, Wiki? Hey, what's up, Zevos? Yeah, thank you. My passion is music, and you're on Periscope, so if you want to check any of my past streams on Scope, you'll see a lot of them that have to do with music. And that's kind of why I'm here this afternoon, is I wanted to, I guess, just do some unboxing. So for those of you who are new to the channel, I trimmed it a little bit, Bruce.
Thank God.
She's like, thank God. Yeah, it changes my face a little bit, but I think my girl and my mom are pretty happy. But anyways, so for those of you new to the channel, I had surgery last week, abdominal surgery, and if you are on Periscope or if you're on YouTube or any of those, you'll be able to check my You'll be able to check my past videos and you'll see that I do what's called live looping. I play drums, I play bass, I play guitar all at the same time. It's all over the place. It's fun and funky and groovy and awesome, and I love it. Okay, cool. Yeah, so I'm glad you guys like this music too. You love the old beard? Thank you, Kat. I think the ladies are going to say that I look better, but I think the guys are going to say that I look better with the beard. I don't know. I have a feeling that's kind of how it's going to go. But anyway. So because of the surgery that I had, I'm not allowed to really lift anything for the next few weeks. So I've realized that, hey, what's going on? I'm doing well. I'm doing much better. So I realized that in order to keep moving, in order to keep performing, in order to keep progressing musically, I was going to have to change up my show a little bit. So I started looking into things that were very lightweight, things that I maybe knew how to do but weren't too comfortable doing. And one of those is playing guitar and DJing at the same time, or playing guitar to like backing tracks and manipulating pre-recorded backing tracks that I either create or that I find and add basically music on top of. So
I typically don't like to do things like that just because I like to create all the sounds myself, but because I'm unable to lift all of the heavy equipment that I currently own that makes me that allows me to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to manipulate my current setup to incorporate both a live and a DJ element, but it's going to flow like kind of like a DJ set, but a live show. And this is, I guess, just basically more of an experimentation of me diving into like what does it mean to be a live performer and what does it mean to be a DJ. So that's exactly what's bringing me to this right here. So this thing I found online just the other day. It's called a Newmark DJ to go 2. I don't know if you guys can read it. I don't know if that's backwards or forwards for you guys. It's a Newmark DJ go 2. It's basically a DJ controller. I currently have a Newmark NV. I'm not partial to Newmark. They just happen to have stuff that I like. That I need to use and that kind of fits what I need. This is like the only controller of its kind. I have a feeling that they're going to be coming out with a lot more of these style controllers in the future just because of its portability. But literally, there is nothing to this. Like it's, I can lift this up without any effort. I can do all, like everything that I do on the big mixer, not everything, 60, 70% of the stuff that I can do on the big mixer, I can do on this. And if I'm going to be utilizing a guitar as well, having something like this is perfect because I don't really need to be going heavy on the DJing, right? Fancy that pie? Yeah, not yet. I haven't really been able. So even though I can, even though I feel a lot better when I sit down, like walking around is still weirdly an effort. Like it feels like something is pulling me down into the earth. At an accelerated rate. That's the only thing I can kind of explain. It's like from my stomach, like still feels like when I stand up that something is pulling me down. So it's a little bit more effort to kind of do shit, which means I'm most likely going to be sitting down or hanging out all day, but that's okay. Yeah, but yes, back to this. This is the smallest thing I've ever seen. And I was super excited because this is going to be, this is basically the start of this whole brand new performance style that I am going to be, that I'm gonna be experimenting with you guys over the next like couple weeks before I start going out and performing it. So this is the first step in a multi-step process and you guys are gonna be coming along with me the entire way and I'm so pumped about it. So here we go, we're gonna open this up. Okay, so before it's, let's see, it's portable pocket size DJ controller that goes with you everywhere. It's literally like the tiniest thing in the world. So we're gonna open this up right here. You guys get to experience this with me. And I also have one other thing that I purchased. It's a little bit bigger and I may need Chelsea to help me with it, but it's actually for my guitar. So that way I can, look at this. Ooh, let's see, maybe we should do it this way. I think this is the actual proper way that it is. There you go. Nice. Oh, cool. Comes with like swag, so you can like rep. Look at these Newmark stickers. That I actually like the Newmark symbol. It's kind of a cool symbol. It almost looks like a biohazard symbol or something. I don't know if you can see that. So yeah, so now I can like, I can tag up shit.
Right.
You know me. You know me, I'm always tagging shit up. All right. okay, it's cool. So it comes with, apparently, this thing was only $80. Like, I'm not even joking. This thing that's gonna literally change my whole performance style was less than $100. It's really cool. I was actually looking at a couple like YouTube reviews of this thing, and a lot of people were saying like, this is probably the best $80 you'll spend. Oh, hi Diane, it's good to see you. This is probably the best $80 you'll spend on like any sort of DJ gear or any sort of music equipment because it can do so much in such a small package. But it comes with DJ Intro. I've never used that. I use just Serato Pro, which is like the main one. Let's see. Oh wow, here's the, this is the directions, that's it. I do have new toys again, Diane. Yeah, I'm constantly getting new toys. And I'm also going to be, unboxing. I just purchased some other things that I'm super excited about. It's a new speaker that literally sounds like the best speaker I think I've heard in a really long time in the tiniest package possible. Kind of going along with the theme that I can't like lift heavy things, you know? So anyways, so I'll be doing an unboxing of that in probably a week and a half. All right, so it comes with, oh shoot, this is cool. Let's see this. Okay, cool. So it's like a USB connection, so I can literally go... Oh, thank you, Diane. Thank you. It's good to see you. So this is kind of cool. How do you guys like this music, by the way? I want to make sure that the vibe is kind of cool. This is, I'm like totally into it. It's actually a Lewis the Child mix. Yeah. I'm like totally into it. If you guys want me to change the vibe, I can totally change it. Vacationer is also a nice like happy, fun, like vibey thing. But anyways, all right, cool. So this is like a, like just a USB. Ooh, where are you? Come on now. There we go. So yeah, cool. Little USB connection here. And then this is kind of cool. This is like an 8-inch to RCA out, which basically means I think you could take this and go right into like a little mixer, which is kind of neat. You can just go like direct out into a little mixer, RCA out, which is like a little perfect DJ setup. Hey, what's up, what's up, what's up? It's good to see you, buddy. All right, so here we go. This is the, what is it called? The piece de resistance? The piece de... I don't know how you say it. I think that's how you say it. I'm not French, but you know. But I can, yeah, it's right. All right, here we go. Christmas in March, hell yeah. All right, here we go. Here we go. Oh wow, this is like, no joke. I swear to God, I don't think this is even a pound. Can you see this? Okay, cool. So it looks like this is the main out. I don't know if you can see that. That's the main out, which I think is what this goes to.
You should try DJing with them.
I should try DJing with you guys. Let's see. Should that be a separate scope or should I just like rock this out?
Rock
it out. Cool. So that's what this is. Interesting. All right. You know what I'm actually gonna do instead of that is we're gonna take I think I'm utilizing it right now. I need an 1/8 inch to 1/4 inch converter so I can so I can plug it into our that little guitar speaker.
you just need to plug those headphones direct in.
Yeah, that's what I'll have to do.
It's just a little bit of a tighter.
Oh, that's fine.
Yeah.
Hey, Chelsea. Hi. She doesn't want to be on camera right now. Let's see. It's actually literally, Chelsea, it's like underneath this thing. I know. I don't know what you were doing there. You were being cord management. All right, so here's this right here. I actually can't, there's ads. Come on now. All right, here we go. So this is the USB connection. So it's actually like a micro USB to USB, which is kind of cool. This is how it goes into the computer. So now let me actually bring my computer over here. All right. Hi, Chelsea. All right, we're bringing the computer over. Oh, neat. This is kind of a cool visual. Cool. All right, let's see.
Where do you need this?
What?
Where do you want this?
Hold on. I need that. This is only the extension. I actually need like a an 1/8 inch to 1/8 inch full cable, which I think might be in my room somewhere.
Why do you need that? So that they can hear you?
Yeah, like I can't connect this to this without that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where is it?
I probably should have grabbed all that stuff beforehand, but I didn't know what was going on in this box until now.
You need the microphone stuff.
What? The microphone's down there. All right, let's see. Connection issues. Uh-oh. Shoot. What? I just need help. I'm not gonna be able to do shit until I I'm totally stuck.
Either go get it or talk.
I can't. I got it. How about let me see. Hold on. I'll be right back, guys. All right. Holy moly. Yeah, we actually have two birds. Holy moly. Okay, so I'm feeling much better. So here's the deal. Because this is an eighth inch out instead of a quarter inch out, my entire plan for being able to, like, just live DJ right here was totally, like, screwed. So we have to basically revamp everything that we've got going on as far as, like, power and outlets and stuff. And what I'm going to do instead, oh my god, this doesn't have an RCA out. Are you kidding me? Let me think. Yeah, no, we're actually going to have to go to the store. We're actually going to have to go to the store now. I can't believe this. Because this actually doesn't have an RCA in. The only RCA in is on my live stuff. And that is literally sitting out there and I can't grab any of that stuff because it's all taped to the board. So I need like an eighth inch cable that goes to a quarter inch out. So basically what I can do at that point is plug it into here, and then from here I can then take it out into the mains. Yeah, so you know what? I will not DJ right now. I think you know what I'm instead? I'll DJ tonight in the other room when it's, I'll just kind of have it all pre-set up and I'll DJ tonight in the other room. So, oh my god, look at this. Look at that. It's literally the size of the little trackpad on my computer. That is too cool. Yamaha mixer. Yeah, I love this little guy. This little guy has been a lifesaver for me for so many DJ gigs. And it has like onboard effects. I don't know if you can see that. It's got like a reverb and a delay built in. So I can usually use this for like small like acoustic gigs too and just kind of throw a little reverb on my voice. And on the guitar? Yeah. What? What? All right, here we go. So, holy crap, look at that. That is too cool. That's like, look at that. Oh my gosh, the whole thing fits right there. Hey, buddy. What's going on, Corey? All right, let's see. Thanks for tuning into the stream. I'm moving this stuff over. Here we go. And so this other thing came from Amazon. I bought it off of Amazon. And it is a little on the large side. Large and awkward.
Don't pull it over there yet. Yeah, cross up the address.
Ooh, that is on my computer. All right. Let's see. What are we listening to? I haven't even heard what we're listening to yet. Let's see here. Oh, there's no music going right now. Step up your guitar here. I wonder why the music stops. Can you guys hear the music? Oh, I think it's me. I don't think it's plugged in anymore.
Would
you mind grabbing that? Alright, cool. So now that we have no address going on here. Alright, so this box is much larger. Let's see here. Here we go. Oh, this is such a great sound. It's a lot different on my end seeing what you guys are saying. And how you guys are talking and stuff is very interesting. Alright, so this kind of goes along with the same thing. Like, I can't really, like, lift heavy things or many things. And so what this is this right here is called an embrace. What's that? Oh, sweet. Yeah, so this thing is called an embrace. I literally think this entire thing is just like padding, because I only ordered the one thing. Oh, this is very interesting. Do you see this? You see that? I'm not even joking, I think that whole box is good for this. Not even joking. What in the hell? Yeah, that whole box is just for this. Alright. Oh God. This is just going horribly. This is going so fucking poorly.
Me.
All right, here we go. Fuck, here we go. All right, so this I also can barely show you. The reason why I can barely show you this is because I literally can't lift anything like more than 5 pounds, and this, I need to be able to lift the guitar in order to put this on. So what this is this essentially acts as like a guitar holder, like the two buttons at the end of the guitar that you use to put your strap on. What this does is it cups around the back end of the guitar instead. And then what you do with it, I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, it's the wrong way, but yes. And what you do with it is it allows you to place the guitar on a stand. There it is. So you don't have to hold it, it's just up, kind of like this. And you're gonna put it up at any level, and put it up on the stand at any level, and you don't need to hold the guitar. So it'll free me up to where I can literally just stand and kind of move around and do the little DJing that I wanna do on that thing once it's all set up, and do the little, you know, drum playing I want to do on the side as well. It just frees me up, so I'm not like relegated to holding like 7 pounds for 4 hours, you know? So this is interesting. Yeah, there it is. Okay, so that's what it is. You can kind of see that. Oop, let me do it in front of the camera a little bit more, right? So I'm unlocking these things. There you go. This is a lot easier to see this way. So this ends up being the strap button right here for the guitar. And then it latches on like that. And then the guitar stays upright on a stand that is connected right there. I don't know if you guys, yeah. Musician tips, yeah. Something like that. Just kind of interesting stuff, I guess. I'm really into this song. I'm looking, can you guys see that thing on the bottom of the screen? What does that say? Does that say Kevin?
Yeah, you need to reset your settings. Are you gonna go onto the OBS experimenting part of your stream?
Well, I was just looking at it, and I just
if you go into Streamlabs, and you go under the widget Stream Boss.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so go over into the settings. You never know what to expect. Come see the show everyone's talking about. Blue Man Group. You gotta see it. You can't describe it.
You honestly can't imagine how exciting. All right. It's totally original. Cool. So that is this. I'm gonna probably set this up, this embrace up, also in my room when I'm doing the DJing later tonight. So hopefully you guys will be able to see that as well. And maybe if it's all set up, I can actually play guitar and sort of experiment with my ideas that I want to hopefully do in an actual live setting.
There it is.
Oh, okay.
Now when someone gets super high.
Oh, that's cool. Stock up on everyday essentials fast? Well, you're in luck. At Walmart.com, you can score everyday low prices on everything from pantry, household, oh, okay. Beauty and personal care must-haves. We'll even deliver your order for free in just 2 days. Yes, get free 2-day shipping on your fave. I'm like, there's freaking. What's playing? Let's see.
It's complicated, isn't it?
It is. There's a lot to do. And also, Pandora is slow as shit. Hey, Brian. Yeah, I'm doing a lot better now. Thank you. Thank you so much, man. It's been a wild ride, but I think I'm past the worst of it, which is kind of cool.
Is that like a radio answer?
Oh, yeah. Come on now. I'm trying to.
There's a lot of BS about HS.
I'm trying to get Pandora to work. Hydrogenitis superativa. Like bad solutions. You know what? That equipment that I just showed you, this guy right here. I'm under the very strong assumption that it's safe. I bought it off of Amazon. It had a really high rating. And I don't think I've seen anything like it. And I don't know if you can see that, but that's trademarked right there, which means they probably came up with this idea, found it had to be like a really good idea, and then just then trademarked it so nobody could steal this sort of design, and then like sort of cornered the market on this thing. So I think it's going to be really good. Yeah, thank you, Brian. I think it's going to be really good. You have no sound or picture. Does anybody else have no sound or picture? What? I don't know. This is absolutely crazy. I have no idea how... I don't know how this whole stream could have like gone any worse. I can't do shit. And everything's just breaking around me.
It's perfect. I think they were trolling you. Look, that's why you keep your Periscope open. So you can just always check.
Oh, I don't think there was any trolling going on.
they say. YouTube broke, but it's all good on Periscope. Oh, so YouTube broke. Shoot. Okay.
You just keep your Periscope open, and then you can keep an eye on what's going on, who's in the room, how many people hate you having there. Don't turn your music on, I mean your noise on. And that way you can see who's in there.
Yeah, let me see. This actually looks really cool, right? on the thumbnail. Oop. It's on, like, literally I can see myself. That's so weirdly meta. Like, looking at myself and myself and like, ah! I'm totally into this song. Can you guys hear this? Alina Perez, I guess? Let's see some similar artists. Taku, Janeiko, yeah. Wow, this is really neat. I would love to get an overlay that just kind of like, I don't know, like does something every now and again, like over the top of the whole thing, you know?
Experiment. You might be, I have no idea how to do it, but you might be able to find something like that in Streamlabs. I wouldn't surprise.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It does look good. Awesome, guys. I'm going to try to recreate. So this is a very specific setup. I'm going to try to recreate this setup. Let me see. There we go. That's kind of cool. I'm gonna try to recreate this setup in my little studio room as well. So let's see, let's try to get like chat box, spin wheel, assist, goals, alert box. Let's see. I'm in Streamlabs right now. Okay, cool, yeah. You can talk again soon? Awesome, dude. Thanks for being in the stream, man. I appreciate it. God, this song rocks. Oh, it's featuring, I think it's Khalid? I'm not entirely sure. Electric. This is awesome. This song, like, makes me want to jam. Yeah. Yeah, I appreciate it, dude. Good to see you. Hey, what's going on? Thanks for joining. Hello, hello, hello. We're just hanging out. I'm trying to figure out a program called OBS. It's kind of a cool broadcasting program. All right, let's see here. Also, I'm just like super digging this song right now. Yeah, you know, what was that? Yeah, I probably could do equipment reviews with this setup. Yeah, and just kind of like jam out on the pedal. That is a great idea.
Right?
Yeah, I'm definitely going to do that. Hey, Purple. Yeah, I'm feeling a lot better. Yeah, have I played since my surgery? Okay, so there. I'm looking down the hall in my house, and there's an electric guitar on the wall. It's hanging on the wall. I played that while it was hanging on the wall. That's, I think, the only guitar playing I've done all week, and it's killing me. It's like absolutely killing me. What up, Adam? So, this is a good one too. This Janae. Mome? M-O-M-E. I've never heard of these people. They've got, like, super vibey music. I'm totally into it. Thank you for the hearts, guys. Alright, let's see here. How do I create just a fun layer? How am I feeling? I'm feeling. Oh, you're digging the music? Awesome. Awesome. I'm glad you are. I'm totally digging this music. It's great, man. I'm feeling a lot better. Like, a lot better. Like, I think I'm past the worst of it, which is awesome. Oops. There we go.
That makes more sense.
You
want to
take off the overhead camera?
What was that?
You want to take off the
overhead
camera?
Oh, yeah, that's right. No, that's kind of cool. Coffee, yeah. Yeah, the place, you know what, I play it like, I play at about 3 or 4 locations fairly regularly, like once a week. And hey, what's going on? How you doing? It's good to see you, Twitch. Rocking and rolling, man. I'm just screwing around with OBS right now. I opened up a couple cool little things that I'm going to be jamming on a little later tonight with another stream that I'm going to be doing tonight. So yeah, it's good to see you, man. Yeah, the place, so I play like 3 or 4 places about once a week, and I let a few people know there that I won't be there, but you know, they're big, busy places, so I haven't let everybody know. I'm very curious to see what people are going to say when I come back, you know, in a couple weeks. If it's even, if they're going to be like, oh, did you go on vacation? Kinda. How you guys doing? Let's see. Oh man, who is this? Mome. Mome? Oh, I think Mome might be the producer DJ, and then the vocalist is Merlinjean. It's gonna be way harder to like pronounce artists these days because all the names have been taken already. They gotta like rewrite the same words. They gotta like do all kinds of crazy shit. It's like, my name's Jim. How do you spell it? Q M L, the number 6. It's like, ah! Can you put on music, please? Ed Sheeran. You know what? That'll be kind of fun, but I think it's gonna like bring down the like, it'll be like super slow-mo. I'll probably throw a little Ed Sheeran on a little bit. Sorry, Ed. Yeah, okay, yeah. Yeah, I've had maybe two cups of coffee since I've, maybe 3 cups of coffee since surgery. So they were delicious and amazing. I've also had some tea. I've also spilled some tea. Like literally and figuratively. All right, let me see here. Oh, this is one of my favorite songs. Oh my God. This is seriously one of my favorite songs. I'm not even joking. Vibe with me. It's called Coming Home. It was originally a song by James Hersey, which is like a singer-songwriter guy. And then, what's his name? Dylan Francis and Kygo came on the track, and they were so much bigger than James Hersey. And I think James Hersey literally sold them his song, and it became their song featuring him, if that makes any sense. Yeah. Can you see that as Dylan Francis? Oh, you like tea as well? Anything with caffeine, right? Remember that song? All I can think about is coming over. You know what? I have 3 scars. I'm gonna have 3 scars. 1, 2, 3 on the side. They didn't do it like in the middle, and thank God I didn't do it in the middle, because apparently I wouldn't be walking right now if they did it in the middle. The recovery period on a cut in the middle of the stomach to repair is like months as opposed to weeks. So the scars that I have, they're gonna be threefold on my right hand side, but they're only about maybe 1 to 1.5 inches long. So it's not gonna be that bad. And then I don't know what the hell's going on in the middle, but I have like a big hole like in the middle of my stomach. I think they like went in to like make sure that the mesh like was like kind of sitting right, you know? So that, I don't know what's going on there, but let's see. Think about it, coming over. Passenger. Man, maybe. We'll see what's going on next on this guy right here. God, I love this song. That what they do right there is right here. They're kind of like creating it and chopping the vocal. That is so a now thing. I don't know, you guys, like I'm saying this now because most pop songs and most like sort of like dancey songs. Yeah, stomach was on a roller coaster. Yeah, I can dive a little deeper into that if you want. But, that was a lot. Anyways, excuse me. Yeah, so that little that vocal thing that like that right there is something that you guys probably hear more than you realize. I think it started with like Diplo and what was it, that song? Yeah, that Bieber song. I think that's where it really kind of took off, when they actually took the vocal line and they chopped it up and created another vocal line, and then like compressed the vocal and frigged with the vocal so much that, yeah, Skrillex was on that track too. Yes, exactly, yeah. I know there's a guy getting featured doing my style looping. His name's Matt Bolton. He is amazing. You guys should follow him. He is so cool. His style of looping is a little bit different than mine. What he does is he kind of like layers in sort of more like ambient tones and ambient noises, more like shaker noise. He's got a shaker that he uses almost every song. And the way that he plays drums is a little bit more, I would say, a little bit more sparse and definitely shuffle beat-esque. Yeah, there is a guy. His name is Matt Bolton. You got to check him out if you haven't. And definitely check out, if you haven't checked out my stuff, be sure to check out my stuff as well, because there's a lot of really cool, unique musicians on this platform, and they all kind of do their own thing. Even though there's a lot of guys that do like looping and maybe even acoustic and electric looping and stuff, there are so many different ways to do it and so many different like thought processes behind creating live production in that way, that there's room for basically everybody that really wants to do it. It's you know, even Ed Sheeran is like light years away from what Matt Bolton does, and Matt Bolton is closer to me, but still way different from what I do. But he is freaking awesome. I like him, and he's a great guy. He jumps on my scopes, I jump on his scopes. We try to stay, you know, in touch somewhat with one another. At least on this platform, you know. Did he get in trouble for that song? I don't know. I don't think he got in trouble for that song. I don't think Bieber did. Oh yeah, he's doing some Beatles. Yes, yeah. His jams, I think, are a little bit more like Bittersweet Symphony, like the Beatles, like you know, maybe even some like ZZ Toppy type stuff. Like he does bluesy stuff. Yeah, I do a little bit, I don't know, it's hard to say what my genre is, but it's very wavy, I would say. It's like kind of wavy, funky. Yeah. Oh, you read that somewhere that he got in trouble for that? Yeah, I feel like Justin Bieber's too big to not put out anything of any substance without some controversy. It just kind of happens innately. Oh, Skrillex used a voice tag. Oh, he stole it. I see what you mean. Yeah, no, that wouldn't surprise me, because that sort of concept, that idea of like taking the vocal, chopping it, screwing it, and making a new melody out of it in the drop, that idea is a very like of the last 3 years and maybe another couple of years, but then somebody's gonna find something new because they are playing that shit out like holy crap. Not that I don't like it, but after a while people are gonna be like, okay, next thing. It's coming in the next couple years, I would say. And then like 10 years, 20 years from now, you're gonna look back and be like, oh my God, do you remember when they did that? It was like, that was like a capsule in time almost, a musical capsule in time. It's kind of cool. This is actually really cool. This is Louis the Child. Yeah, Matt Bolton's doing some Beatles. He would do some Beatles. He probably knows a lot of Beatles stuff. I would imagine Matt Bolton knowing most of the Beatles catalog. And probably some Beach Boys and stuff too as well. Then there's another guy, Chris Gayle's on this platform, that's really cool as well. He's like sort of Periscope's like main music guy. Everything about everything but music, I don't know about all that. I do, you know what it is? It's almost like there's a course or two. There's actually a whole field of study called musicology, and it really weirdly interests me. It's how music and sociology and psychology and religion and all that kind of stuff, how they all like interplay into one another, and how music is a reflection of a lot of stuff and vice versa. And that kind of thing like really interests me. That interests me almost as much as performing. And when I was in college, I took a couple musicology classes. They were super cool. We did like essays on why, you know, Woodstock was important for society and stuff. It was cool as hell. Mama Care Bear, what's going on? See the guy here from the UK? Who is the guy here from the UK? Hello, hello, it's good to see you. Thanks for joining the stream. Hey, everybody that's new here, be sure to follow me. I'm gonna be doing some pretty quirky stuff tonight. I'm gonna be streaming again tonight here on Periscope and on Twitch and on YouTube. I'm gonna be really trying to go for some interesting new performance ideas, I guess. I'm gonna utilize a really cool little thing that I just opened a little while ago. It's a Newmark DJ controller that's literally the size of this little trackpad right here. And then I'm gonna hopefully get my guitar set up and jam it out and stuff. And I've got some tracks that I found online that are kind of weird and quirky from YouTube, and I'm gonna try to jam on top of them. I'm doing well, thank you, Andre. Thank you. The gut, Ron, the gut is doing well. The gut is, it's healing now. It was getting a little worse before it was getting better, and I was fearing for the worst, but we made a turnaround, and by we, I mean me and my stomach, because I had ideas, and my stomach had its own ideas for a couple days, so we made a good turnaround together, and it was wonderful. I'm very happy about it. This is actually amazing, this song. I want to get the track to this song. This is Russ. Oh man, Russ is so good. What was that? Who's that? What is that song that he has? He's got this amazing song. Let me see. I'm feeling a lot better. In general, I like, what was it yesterday? I walked almost a mile, I think, or maybe even more than a mile. Actually, yeah, thank you so much, Ron. I really appreciate that. Yeah, I'm going to, once I jump up the stream, I'm going to try to do one more lap. There's like in our neighborhood, there's like a small lap and a big lap. Hi, Chelsea. What's up, Chels? There's like a small lap and a big lap. The small lap is like a little bit, man, this song kills. The small lap is a little bit over a half mile, and the big lap is a little bit under 2 miles. So my goal is to be able to get to a point where I can like walk the 2 mile thing. I haven't gotten there yet, but I'm getting to the point where I can walk two of the small ones. So Losing Control, that's the song. And What They Want. Where are you, Russ? I feel you, man. This is almost not hip hop. Like I think he's touted as something of a hip hop artist, but that was very like, I don't know. That was way more like a future bassy kind of like down tempo song with actual like vocal parts. It was not really a hip hop song. Let's see what the next one is, huh? Oh, Cherub, they're great. Oh, what are we using to split the screen, Ron? I am using OBS. This is actually a studio that we built at the house, mainly for Chelsea and for her painting. But I'm utilizing it here today, and then I will be hopefully creating my own little version of this tonight in my studio, my music studio. Hopefully what the plan is to create a little situation where I can do exactly what is going on here, where I can kind of plug my computer in, plug in maybe a couple webcams, and just get ready and go and be able to like perform for you guys in my actual little demo studio. Oh yeah, look, reppin' Newmark. But that is the ultimate goal. So I can actually do, there's a couple guys on Periscope as well that do more like intimate type shows where they'll play like a song on, you know, on YouTube and they'll jam along to it, or they'll play like just a backing track and they'll just solo over it and stuff. So that's my plan, is to be able to do something like this visually where you guys can see each other talking, where instead of it just being like a place just for Periscope, we can have like a place for everything, for Twitch, Periscope, and YouTube, for all of my channels to kind of hang out together on stream. And then for me to just be able to like jam and talk and shoot the shit with you guys. I think that'd be so much fun. Yeah. Hold on, let me see. Oop. Yeah, no, I, you know what? That would actually be a great idea. I'm actually still working that out, to be quite honest. It's kind of hard. It's very, very difficult to not only just figure this out, but like figure it out to a point where you can actually teach other people how to do it. So like I'm still in the phase right now where I'm figuring it out. Like I would love to be able to have, for example, like right now, instead of it just being, you know, just being this, I would love to be able to have like a possible layer on top of this that like kind of like flutters every now and again, or like does something interesting visually for you guys. So it's, what was it? Oh, maybe Stream Labels, you think, instead of Stream Labs?
No. Maybe Stream Labs is a widget called Stream Labels.
Oh, okay.
That might allow you to do some sort of overlay with, like, your socials.
Oh, that would be sick. Mm-hmm. There's Stream Labels. Yeah, there we go. What is Stream Labels? Thanks for those hearts, guys. I appreciate that. Thank you. It's weird. It's like I'm sitting down, but I'm doing more than sitting down. It's a strange sensation, ladies and gents. Not gonna lie. But yeah, you know what? I think what I'm gonna do, Ron, to your point, I may actually just do like, you know what they do on YouTube where they have like just a series of like, this is, you know, this is this type of pedal, or this is this type of guitar, do whatever. And I may do like actually, oh, you're hopping off? It's good to see you, buddy. Take care, Adam. I'm feeling much better. Thank you. Thank you so much, man. Thank you so much. But yeah, I may do not only just Gary's, but I may just do like reviews in general. I think that would be a lot of fun. To kind of take the editing out of that, those sort of like gear reviews, and just be live and loose with it and be more like interactive, so you guys can ask questions. And maybe if I have like some pedals that I really like, I can kind of do question when I scope. On your scope and you're feeling better, y'all had some big news. Did you miss the big news? I think you did miss the big news.
No, I didn't do a scope announcing.
Oh, you didn't do a scope announcing it?
Okay.
Apparently you didn't miss the big news. What's going on? Garormus. Garormus. Wow, that's a great name. So that big news has not been revealed officially yet. So Chels was on last night. She was doing some watercolors and making some beautiful unicorns and horses and things. And she let it slip, because she's terrible at surprises. She let it slip a little bit as to what the big news was. But she hasn't done an official scope. And I think that would actually be kind of cool to just do like one quick official scope before you jump on tonight. Yeah. So anybody that was in her scope, and she's C-G-O-O-O-D-S, if you guys are in here and don't know. Sup, Holmes? She is C-G-O-O-O-D-S. And if you want to jump on her last scope, it's, how long was it? It was a couple hours though. So
I don't even know what I said.
It yeah, is. It was a long one, and she doesn't know when she said it. So we can't spill the beans. What's up? It's good to see you, man. Yeah, no. Oops, no. Don't worry about it. It's actually I think what she'll do is she'll do like a legit like big news blast on scope tonight. and then jump back on afterwards after maybe talking about it, taking some questions, I don't know, being excited about it, like, holy shit, and then jumping on after that to do some more painting. Possibly in conjunction with that same big news, right? The painting could possibly be in conjunction with the big news or not. I don't know. She's giving me one of these. It could either be a get the hell off me with the questions, or it could be a I will let you know later. Little teaser. Exactly, Ron. Little teaser. I'm going to go with the nicer of the two.
Stop.
Act like she's a nice person. Oh my god. Gotta jump through those ads. This is kind of cool. So that little thing in the middle is the tip jar. So anybody that throws super hearts my way, a little thing pops up on that bottom area. Let me see if I can point to it. Can I point to it? Nope, this way. Right there. There it is. I think I can grab it. No. It's with her. That's a great one, Ron. It's actually with regards to her career. With regards to Periscope and all that, and the whole, basically this entire overarching experiment that she's been doing with painting and with, you know, building up just her catalog of art. That's what it has to deal with. So it's actually like an amazing, amazing new step for her. And so we're super excited about it. And he goes, because like, I don't want to say like too much because I don't want to like give it away myself, but that's pretty much what it is. Has an amazing new step in her career and a possible like new avenue for her. So friggin' awesome. I'm not going to lie. Ooh, let's see what kind of song we got going on right now. Oh, Kiara, two eyes. That's what I'm saying. There are not enough. It's like too many artists out there. There's just not enough names left, so they got to make up their own names. This is Kiara with two eyes. I don't know if you can hear that. Let me see. I'm gonna put it up a little louder. All right, let's see. Let me see here. A spin wheel. What is a spin wheel? Let's see. We're gonna try to screw around with some stuff on Streamlabs here and blow it up and see if it works. Oh, a little hamburger, hot dog, pizza slice. So you can actually like...
What?
This is called a spin wheel.
Oh, I have no idea what that is.
What is a spin wheel?
I know that, I have no idea.
Yeah, I'm gonna copy this and see what it means. All right, so we're gonna add a spin wheel.
For what?
I have no...
Are you putting different song names on it? And then
well, no, it says hamburger, hot dog, and pizza slice.
Right, no, but you probably can change the categories. You know what I mean?
Ooh, okay.
Like, you could change it to, like, four different songs, and then you spin it, and then that's the song that you play next.
This is interesting.
It's probably something like that, where you can pick the categories and make your own game with the deal. I'm assuming. I don't know. I've never
used
it.
Catch you on the replay? All right, Ron. It's good to see you, buddy. Thanks for tuning into the stream. And everybody that's new here, be sure to follow me. I'm going to be doing some really cool stuff musically. This is a music channel. I'm experimenting with some new stuff while I'm recovering from a little surgery. But I'm going to be getting back to music as soon as I possibly can. What smells so good right now?
Give me pizza.
Give me some pizza. Pizza, pizza. Pizza, pizza. What's up, boys? All right, we're going to... I mean, I'm just gonna see what the frig this does.
gonna add this bad boy on here. Browser source. We're gonna. Okay, what is this called? Spin wheel. I don't know what this is gonna do, guys, but we're gonna try it out right now. Alright. Did nothing. Let me see.
It's probably a flute at the front.
It just says OBS Studio. Shit. Oh, it doesn't. It started out by saying that, and now it doesn't.
You need to probably change the dimensions on it.
It's the biggest it could be. It was like that. It's like the generic size. God, this song rocks. Okay. Oh, it's that same one. Whippin'. What? Leave for what? Oh, thank you so much. It's for Coco? Oh yeah, we're gonna go head over to Coco. Oh, this is a cool story. Chelsea's little brother, who lives in Michigan, surprised her and us a couple days ago and with news that he is coming down to Florida for spring break. So he's a freshman in college, so it's kind of like that typical freshman year of college. I want to get out of the cold, and I'm a big grown-up now, and I can party a little bit harder than I used to. So we're going to go. Yes, I did. I got a bunch. I got, not a bunch, but I got a few new toys that I'm very excited about. Actually, would you mind grabbing that DJ console thing? It's like sitting right here. Well, yeah, so we're going to be heading over to go see her brother. We're going to grab some dinner with him tonight, and then probably after that, we're going to head back. Wait, what time is it? 6:45. Yeah, 6:45. Okay, yeah, we should probably head out at about 7, I would say. I think it's 6:30. Yeah, it's 6:30. Yeah, we should head out at around 7, I would say. Especially if we want to scope it at some point before like the midnight tonight, you know. Yeah, this is the first toy that I got. This is actually going to help me perform live on guitar. What this does is this attaches basically to the back end. You can actually see it better on the...
Maybe I can take him out to breakfast in the morning. Because we're already going to be heading that way.
Yeah. Unless he really wants to see you tonight. Oh, text him. See what's going on. Yeah, so this is the first toy. It's kind of crazy. This you can see it better this way. This attaches itself into basically like any sort of music stand. Kind of screw it in, right? And then this side, boom. Petite Biscuit, that's the name of this song. That's a new kind of name. I'm really into that name. Petite Biscuit. All right, so yeah, so then this goes in the back end of the guitar, right? Have I tried singing yet? Great question. This goes in the, what? This goes in the back end of the guitar. Hey, what's up? And it attaches itself onto the back end of the guitar. There we go. And then it sits onto a stand like that. So that way the guitar is being held up by the stand instead of me. So that's my first little purchase that I made in order to allow me the freedom to not have a 6 or 7 pound guitar on my back. It's gonna free up like my core in a big way, and I'll be able to actually perform for a lot longer. So that's the first little, like, kind of cool unboxing thing that I did today. Or excuse me, the second one. The first one was this bad boy. I don't know, you can see it better on the overhead, but I'll do it this way. There you go. You can see it really well this way. Maybe like that. Okay, cool. So this right here is a Newmark DJ to go to. Yeah, it's kind of cool. I'm like super into it. It's a Newmark DJ to go to, and it is essentially a really, really, really tiny DJ controller, and when I say really tiny, I mean like, look at that. Legit the size of this like trackpad here. But look, it's got little jog wheels, like I can like
I can jump. I can't scratch on this thing. It doesn't scratch, which is the one thing I'm a little bit like eh about. But I can, you know, you basically have four trigger points, four cue points essentially that you can stop and start a song at. You can sync, you can cue. It's got essentially all of the things that you would need to like DJ at a very basic level, which if I'm gonna be playing guitar and, you know, playing a drum kit, that electronic drum kit and stuff, I'm only gonna be needing the DJ at a very basic level. And I most likely won't even be DJing the whole time. It'll probably be, you know, maybe 20 minutes of straight DJing live music and then maybe a 2 minute break to reset and get some stuff together, kind of like a live show meets a DJ gig. So this is the other thing that I got, and I'm gonna be utilizing this tonight, hopefully, to, thank you so much, Carrie. I appreciate that. I feel so much better, so much better. Even Chelsea said that new life has been brought into my eyes the last day and a half, which I'm super grateful for. So, yeah, so this is basically allows me to do all the DJing that I'm gonna be needing to do in order to get through this new kind of like hybrid show that I'm gonna be putting together with you guys starting hopefully tonight. I have a doctor's appointment, a follow-up appointment for my surgery tomorrow. Monday morning, I have a follow-up. So I'm gonna be heading back down to South Florida tomorrow, and I won't be scoping tomorrow night, but I'm starting Monday, I'm going to be scoping at least a few hours a day working on this brand new show that I'm gonna be putting together, just kind of going over songs, re-going over songs, like reinterpreting songs that I currently have, maybe even finding new backing tracks and new interesting, like, I don't know, anything that would give me sort of a different approach to performing with tracks. And that's exactly what I'm going to try to do with you guys over the next, I want to say, week and a half, 2 weeks. Thank you so much for all the hearts. You guys rock. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So yeah, so that's what this is. It's basically like the coolest little to-go DJ console thing. And it's actually way, way more ridiculous than I thought. I'm no joke, I'm going to have to buy, I don't know if you can see that. That is an 1/8-inch cable. I'm gonna have to buy an 1/8-inch to 1/4-inch or 1/8-inch to XLR, which I find to be crazy. Or I'll have to find, or I can get an adapter that goes from 1/8-inch to 1/4-inch out, and then I can utilize it that way as well. But damn, that's so nuts. So this is an 1/8-inch out that I'm gonna have to utilize to DJ. It's gonna be a pretty interesting little experiment with you guys. I'm looking forward to doing it. I know I'm probably gonna sound terrible on the outset, but hopefully we can get through it together. And at some point, I will sound like, hey, this shit's coming together. This is actually gonna be like a show. This could actually like make sense. We'll see. We'll see what happens. So what did the bro say?
He said, yeah. He goes, I'm down with tonight, but it's just out of your way. I don't want to get half of it. What's easier?
I mean, honestly, it is easier to head over there tomorrow. Yeah. If you want, we can just get up.
Like
we can try to get up like ridiculously early and just do breakfast with him.
Well, I don't know if he's gonna get up
ridiculously early. Well, like we get up ridiculously early and get there by like 8 or 9.
Yeah.
You know?
What time do you want to be
there? Like I don't want to be there like late at night because the appointment's tomorrow morning. Yeah, all in good time, baby steps. Exactly. It's been great. Like the corner I turned a couple days ago has really allowed me the ability to like there was like almost a weird extra stress going on because of all the weird side effects and complications, for lack of a better term. So now that those are not a part of the equation, it almost like is a relief. So I feel like I can actually start to heal. And I've been told that, I actually was told today by a friend of mine, that if I didn't have laparoscopic surgery, that I wouldn't even be barely sitting up right now. I'd still be like laying in bed. And it's been over a week. It's been a week and a couple days. Last Wednesday. So yeah, it's been almost a week and a half at this point. And I have basically, Oh, how am I doing split screen? Yeah, oh, I apologize for not answering. It's through a program called OBS. It's a free program that you can find online. It takes a lot of getting used to. I would absolutely give yourself some time to learn this program and to experiment and to mess up on this program, because you absolutely will. And if you don't give it the time that it deserves, thank you. Oh my God. Pizza delivery. Can you see that? Bam. Yeah, it's called OBS. And through OBS, OBS is like a central broadcasting program. And then I have two webcams. This is, it's just a little tiny webcam up here above, and then a webcam straight up. And I utilize those webcams as sources in OBS, and then split the screens, and then utilized Restream and Streamlabs in order to get all of these. Hold on. You can get a bigger bed. This guy right here. You see this guy? No matter the brand. This bad wording, but you look like you were knocking on death's door in Eliza. Yes, I agree with you. I agree with you. OBS, you're exactly right. This right here is through Streamlabs, though. What you're looking at, this sort of chat in the screen, and this below me right here, that's also through Streamlabs. That right there is something that I'm still going to be working on for a while. I don't know what the hell I'm doing as far as Streamlabs and making this more unique. And oh yeah, this right here. I don't know if you can see it. Right there, that little beer can. Can you see the beer bottle with the little tip jar in it? That's also through Streamlabs as well. But everything that I just talked about all goes into OBS in a very specific way. And then it gets broadcast out of OBS onto all of the platforms, mainly Periscope right now. But I was also doing, I think, Twitch and YouTube. I think they, I think those two streams died or something. But yeah, I'm using only one CPU. Yeah, I'm actually using this guy right here. This that you're looking at right now. This is what's streaming. This is actually what I'm using to stream. But I have a screen as well. Yeah, there is. Yes, that is typical, especially for like a laptop. Like I don't have. We're right now. We're kind of building up sort of a better understanding of what we want as far as like strength in processing power and but also portability, because we do move around our studios a lot, and we don't want to have like a huge setup that we can't move anywhere. But we Chelsea and I both realize that we're gonna need like some like a pretty heavy-duty computer to do this full-time, or at least a couple heavier-duty-er computers to do it. Hold on, I haven't taken a bite of pizza yet. This is my first, I'm not even joking, it's like my first real bite of like good pizza. I just got, yo, what's up, Ryan? How you doing, bro? This is actually cool, Hermitube. I see that Twitch is still on. I love you, dude. It's good to see you, man. We're just jamming out and this and talking shit and eating this really like very tiny pizza. Oh my God, yeah. It's like an hour drive. Okay. Your brother's about an hour away from here. I got you. Mm-hmm. I think we should grab him in the morning. We're gonna go grab breakfast with her brother, who lives in Michigan, but drove all the way down to Cocoa Beach for spring break with his buddies. I love this thing. Hey, Diane. Good to see you again. Thank you for coming in. All right. What kind of equipment am I unboxing? Well, you're up. It's a great question, Ryan. You're actually looking at one of them right here. I don't know if you can see that. Am I feeling 100% yet? You know what? My spirits are almost 100%. I would say that's the closest thing to 100% right now. I can't lift anything. Like anything, which is why I bought this, which is why I'm having this unboxing. The pizza's great, Diane, thank you. This thing weighs literally like a pound, maybe less than a pound. And this is gonna allow me to actually like manipulate backing tracks instead of literally just playing them on an iPod or like hitting the space bar and stuff. So this is the first thing that I unboxed today, Ryan. Yeah, I know, I'm sorry, Ryan. The video and audio aren't quite synced right now. I think Pandora is pulling a lot of power right now. And also I think this computer's been on a while. So I'll probably just chill for just a couple more minutes. Yeah, I am working on my new show. This is the very, very, very first step, Diane, of the new show style. And it has to deal with this unboxing right here. I'm sorry for the lag for video and audio. I'm gonna try to get that fixed. We're both gonna try to get that fixed. It happens a little bit with Chelsea as well. And then the other thing that I unboxed was this thing. And this is gonna basically hook onto my guitar from behind. And then it sits on a stand right here. And that stand literally holds up the guitar, so I don't have to hold the guitar anymore. So it'll free me up to where I can like play the guitar. When I walk over, play the guitar. I walk over and I play, you know, my electronic drums. I can DJ a little bit here. If you want a little visual, oh wait, I think it's this way. That's what it does. That's behind is on the left, and then in front is on the right. And so it allows the guitar to like stand up on its own. It's kind of cool. If I didn't know about your surgery, you're feeling good as new. Oh, well, thank you. Yeah, honestly, my spirits are at pretty close to 100%. I still can't, I literally can't lift a single thing. Like my phone, maybe. This thing is a pound, some pizza, you know. But I can't do anything of any substance. So in that regard, I feel very not 100%. But as far as just being able to think without being in constant pain, like, oh my God. Like when with the first update after the surgery, I wish I could frame it in a better way, but like I literally hadn't eaten or had anything to drink in, no joke, 4 days. Like it was 4 days of no food and no liquid. And I don't know if anybody's ever tried to do that, but that literally like drains you to a point where you can barely like keep your eyes open. So that first update was like sort of at the lowest point. Like as far as my spirit, as far as like all of that stuff is in there, like the effects of all of the bullshit narcotics that the extra narcotics that they gave me and all that stuff, the effects were in full swing and had taken full effect at that point. And then right after that, I started, I think that the turnaround came about like 12 to 24 hours after that. So once that happened, it was awesome. It was absolutely awesome. I could start drinking, I could start eating. The baby steps were the smallest of baby steps, but they were baby steps, you know? I lost a ton of weight. I probably lost 12 or 15 pounds in the last week and a half. And that's with me, like, trying to eat. What is that controller, John? That's a great question. It is called a Numark DJ To Go 2. This is the first thing that I unboxed in this very first, in this stream right here. And this is going to be part of a new live setup that I have for my live shows that I will be performing, you know, around town and for Periscope. So this is going to be a big, like very big, although very small component to the new live show. Oh, you play guitar, Ryan? Are the diaphragm spasms better? Yeah, they're a lot better. I'm no longer getting acid reflux. Like I'm no longer like feeling like it's gonna come up. So I they're way, way, way better. Thank you. And I think that was just because like my body was just freaking out. Like my guts had totally shut down from all of the fentanyl that they gave me. So, yeah. So that the spasms have gone away. Only guitar, and you know where you're a pro at it, Ryan. You don't like know any theory, but you can play a song. Yeah, yeah, and you know what, Ryan? That's actually, I was at that space. What happened to me? Oh, dude, I had abdominal surgery last week, actually. And you know what, Ryan? You're on Twitch, so I mainly thank you for tuning into the Twitch stream. I mainly stream on Periscope, and I'm gonna be doing way more Twitch streaming now that I understand a little bit better this new setup. But on Periscope, it's the same handle, I am Rob Hayes, and on Periscope, I let everybody know that I had abdominal surgery Wednesday of last week. So, hey, what's up, Sawil? Hey, it's good to see you. And I'm typically a live loop performer, which means I play drums, guitar, and bass all at the same time, Ryan. So the surgery kind of knocked that out of me, which is why I'm doing these unboxings. I'm trying to find new ways to replicate or at least create something similar to what I was doing before the surgery in the interim while I'm getting better. It's going to take about 4 to 6 months from what I can tell, about 4 to 6 months. Until it's going to take about four to six months for me to get completely and fully better. So I am creating a brand new live show in order to continue to perform without necessarily needing to lift 50-pound speakers and 40 pounds of equipment and stuff like that. So that's what's going on. And this is the first piece of the puzzle. I got another piece of the puzzle over here, which allows me to play guitar without actually holding the guitar. It's going to be held for me. And then what I also am going to be doing is I'm going to be utilizing my computer, and I'm going to be utilizing specifically Serato, which is what Newmark. I don't know if you can see this. Let me see if I can get this up. There we go. There it is, Serato. Hey, what's up? Serato is the program. There it is, Serato. That's the program that is connected with Newmark, and that's the program I use to DJ. So I'm gonna be essentially like, it's like live looping, but instead of creating the sounds from scratch, you gotta go. Oh, thank you. Yes, I will say hi to Chelsea. Thank you so much for joining the stream, man. I appreciate it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You rock. Yeah, I know, I need to fatten up. Hawaii has great food. I know, I had some Hawaiian food in Seattle. The Spam was outrageously good. Spam sandwiches or something like that? Spam sliders? Oh my god, they were amazing. Yeah. Yeah, so yes, exactly, exactly. So what Ed Sheeran does is very, very percussive on the acoustic, right? So I used to do that. I did that like for about 2 or 3 years, Ryan. When do you think he can be back at Bahama Breeze? My next scheduled show is in 2 weeks, but we will see. We will see. And in the meantime, though, I'm going to be performing way more. I actually am excited because this was the kind of big piece of the puzzle. You have a looper pedal for your guitar, but you don't have the money right now to get a keyboard. Yeah, no, it takes a lot, dude. It took me the better part of 3 or 4 years to get the loop station set up that I currently have. You know what? If you want to check out my YouTube channel, you'll see I play acoustic on that. And on Periscope, that's sort of my latest shows. I play electric now. You know, the White Keys, but none of the Black. Black Keys is a great band, though. So if you want to check out my latest shows, Ryan, all you gotta do is jump on my Periscope channel, which is like a mobile app connected to Twitter. I don't know if you do that, but you'll be able to see my latest shows. But I do have some videos out on YouTube, and I'm gonna be releasing a YouTube video next week, which will be great. And you can check out my YouTube channel, and it'll explain exactly what I do as far as live looping, which Ed Sheeran does is very much geared towards the. It's very much geared towards, man, it's hard to explain. He plays the acoustic songs and then builds accordingly. I want to play with a full band, so I create a band around me. And that is literally how I approach live looping. It's like, I used to perform all over the country, as long as I don't lift anything. Yeah, no. Hawaiian people love Spam. Yes, they are very creative with their recipes there. And they're actually really good. But yeah, so I approached it as more of, I used to tour with a band a lot. I love the sound of a full band. I like guitars, I like bass, I like drums, I like synth, I like all of that sort of energy. How can I replicate that as best I can with zero stage volume by myself? That was sort of like the overarching goal that I had, Ryan. And so when I first started doing it, it was just small loop pedal, and I would be hitting my guitar kind of like an Ed Sheeran thing. And then I bought like a vocal pedal that allows me to build vocal harmonies on trigger then. Then I bought like an effects pedal to make my guitar sound like a million different things. And then I bought another pedal that does gain control so I can add a drum kit. And I bought a little electronic drum kit. So like all of a sudden like I had this huge setup, but it took like 2 to 3 years before I was able to actually like put it all together. And it's most likely going to be that same way with you. So don't worry if all you do is the acoustic live looping, because that shit is hard to begin with. And if you start there, you can grow in a million different ways and do a million different things. Kind of like what, I don't know if anybody else here was on Periscope when we were talking about Matt Bolton, but he's yet another cool dude that does live looping. And even Chris Gales does some light live looping on Periscope, all on Periscope. So a $400 Shure SMB7 and like a 6-pedal looper. Dang. Yeah. No, I have a, an RC300, which is just a 3-channel stereo looper. And that, honestly, sometimes it can, that even that can be too much. A lot of the time it's not enough, but I make do with it, and I'm able to kind of utilize my live guitar playing, or I was up until surgery, and maybe a little back when I get back to it. I was able to utilize my guitar and my guitar effects as almost like two instruments. So like the guitar itself plays a layer, but then the effect of the guitar, like the reverb or the distortion or something like that, also creates yet another effect. So it sounds like way more people are on stage than just me, you know? Yeah, yes, you are right, man. You are right. What app do I need to load to get your music on my phone? You know what? I would add Spotify. I'm doing my very best to promote my Spotify, although I am on Apple Music as well. But I'm more focused on my Spotify account. Thank you so much for the super hearts, Diane. Oh my God. Oh, that's really cool how they like get thrown up like that. You rock. Oh my gosh. And look. Hey, there it is. Yeah, Diane, look at you. Do you see the tip jar? It's moving. It's moving and grooving. I don't know. I don't know. You're talking about that thing on the bottom left? It's not. I wonder why. Yeah, no, it's not. Let me see. I'm gonna try to redo that real quick, guys. This song rocks, by the way. Thank you so much, Diane. That was awesome. All right, so which one was that one? Stream Boss. Okay, cool. We're gonna do stream. We're gonna try this Stream Boss again. Here we go. I don't know if it's actually working, but that's the thing. Man, this is so great. We're gonna have to mess with that. It's still not working. I mean, it's a cool little thing to have on the bottom there, but like, it's not doing anything. But pizza does something. Okay, good. I'm glad you're not driving. Oh my God, super hard. Slow. Oh, what's up, Snacks? Wow, YouTube's here too. It's good to see you, bud. That's too cool. That's so awesome. I actually thought YouTube, I thought the YouTube stream ended. I'm streaming simultaneously on Twitch, YouTube, and Periscope, and it is super cool. I love what is happening right now. I'm like so into this, even though I suck at it right now. But I am into pizza. I'm gonna make it bigger. How's that? What was that? Oh, you gotta go? Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you so much for joining the stream. Thanks for hanging out. Oh, I think you're right. It is working. Oh, it's starting to work now. Yes, that little stream bot thing is working. You haven't had pizza until you've been here. Oh, my God. Ryan, let me tell you something. Chels, I've never been to New York. I've toured through New York about two dozen times-ish. Is there something in the oven right now?
No.
It's on 450. Making pizza? Yeah, dude, Ryan, honestly, like, you are 100% right. I personally like that. Just that region has great pizza, though, for real. I am. I'm connected to all three platforms, Diane. It's crazy. I'm super excited about it. This is a brand new, like, frontier for me. But yeah, Ryan, you are totally right, dude. Like, no joke. New York pizza, and I personally like New Jersey pizza, like the Hoboken area. They've got, like, these ginormous pizzas that are, like the size of an entire pie, but it's like a slice. You live in New York. She asked him in New York. Yes. Oh my God, dude, Ryan, I'm telling you, like, you were 100% right. What did I say? Like, we gotta go to New York, we gotta get the pizza, and then we gotta go to Jersey and get the crumb cake.
You wanna show them the difference?
Yes, I would love to show them the difference. Yeah, let me move this. I'm gonna move this back for you guys real quick. And to give you guys a nice little comparison, so this is, to give you an awesome, thank you so much for that. To give you a comparison, this is the Newmark controller I just purchased. Oop, here we go. Hey, it is cool. It's good to see you. What's up, Leah? Or Lesh? Leash? I can't really read that. I think it's Leash. What's up? What's up, Spain? It's good to see you. Catalonia. Man, I would love to visit Catalonia, Spain. Okay. Is pizza my new favorite food? Oh, man. Pizza has always been a fave. Okay, so here's the difference, right? Actually, you can, it'd be cool. I'll just lift it up so you can see it kind of like this. This is upside down, right? Like, you can kind of see a difference. This is what I usually DJ on. And, hold on, let me see. I'm gonna put this down now. And then this is what I'm going to be DJing. What's up, England? This is what I'm gonna be DJing on. Look at the difference. Watch. Looks like it's like baby brother or something. Or it looks like this, like spit this out. It's like, I don't need this part. This is what I'm gonna be DJing on. Yeah, it's so small, isn't it? What's up?
But it's the same, is it the same brand?
It's the exact same brand. You can kind
of
tell.
What parts of this brand?
Oh, that's a great question. So check this out. It's kind of interesting. Yeah, it's very, very, very basic. Yeah, it is like, it's literally like, no joke. Look, it's probably one, you could probably fit 9 of these in my Newmark NV, which is crazy. Oh, you gotta show me that. Yeah, this is the new baby brother. I will absolutely show you how it works because tonight, a little later, I'm gonna be jumping in my studio, plugging this bad boy in and going to town, seeing how it works.
You need the cable, right?
I'm gonna need the cable, yeah. We'll have to go grab the cable real quick, but that's not too big of a deal. What was that?
Where are we gonna go?
We can either go to like Best Buy, any place that has cables. I'll call. Once I jump off, I'll call to see, because I know exactly what cables we need. I know exactly what cables we need. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, I'm trying to change it up a little bit too. I like performing for you guys, and I would perform as often as I possibly could if I could. But right now I'm a little bit under the weather and recovering from surgery. So we're gonna be doing some kind of unique and different scopes until I can get back into performing. And then I'm gonna continue to kind of change it up. I love doing this on my channel. I love exploring like new stuff. So yeah, Ryan, about that, I will absolutely be doing this later tonight. Once I find the right cable that I can connect to all of my equipment, I will absolutely be performing and showing this little guy off. And I'm probably gonna be sucking at it for a little while, so bear with me if you can. But hopefully over time, I will become a little bit more proficient at this guy, because this is essentially the same thing as this, which is essentially the same thing as any sort of remote control. It's like a Wiimote or like a whatever, but it looks like this. It just controls parameters on a program. That's all it does. So as long as I get like comfortable with it, it should work just as well as this guy. Maybe not just as well, but yeah. Yeah, okay, cool. Oh, nice, Ryan. Enjoy your bowling, dude. That's awesome. I haven't bowled in like 10 years. And I don't think I can bowl right now with my stomach in the way, but I think that's gotta be like a fun night out. Maybe the two of us will go one day. Once I'm actually like feeling better. Have a good, I don't know, what game? Couple games? Enjoy the beers? Talk to you later, Ryan. Thanks for joining the stream, man. Sorry. I know, I'm really missing playing my Bahama Breeze shows too, Dan. But this is gonna be, I normally do sing and I normally do play. I'm gonna be doing a lot more of that soon, so. Yeah, I know, it's almost like I'm live, but not really. I know, it's kind of annoying. Believe me, it is just as frustrating for me as it is for you to not be able to play. It might even be a little bit more. Maybe a little bit more. And I don't mean that as like a, it's just, I really want to freaking play. Oh, okay, cool, yeah. Dude, have fun, man. I hope you get a, what is it, a turkey? Is that what it is? Three strikes in a row? It's a turkey? I wish you all the turkeys, my man. I think that's how.
That's a weird thing to say.
I can't laugh too loudly. Because it hurts, but. I wish you all the turkeys, my friend. That is so crazy, the difference. Who is this shit? Look at the size of this and this. Look at that. So here are the similarities, ready? Let me bring this back down. Obviously, obviously, if you look at this, you can kind of tell that there are a couple similarities just right off the bat. For example, this logo and this jog wheel. This is called a jog wheel. So this represents like a CD, you know. This represents like the tiniest CD ever. Yeah, I know. Isn't it crazy? It's so crazy, Monica. So that's essentially the jog one. What this allows you to do is when you hit play, or when you hit play, what happens is 9 times out of 10, you're not gonna be spot on as far as like your mix. The song that you want to mix into the song that's already playing is most likely like gonna be a little bit off, whether it be a little fast, a little slow. And so what this does, this little jog wheel, it allows you to kind of nudge the song a little bit forward or nudge the song a little bit further back. And that's the same thing with this. Excuse me. You can nudge the song forward or nudge the song back, depending upon, you know, what you need to do in order to get the song mixed in. The other thing, the other thing that that I noticed right off the bat is that the actual, like, this allows you to speed up or slow down the song right here. So that is actually the same on here as well. So if, for example, you want to like beat match by ear instead of saying like syncing it, which that's kind of what I do, because what else do you do when you DJ besides beat match? So I know, it is really cute compared to this monster, isn't it? And believe it or not, for Rutgers. This guy right here that I have is small compared to some other giant like DJ consoles. But back to it, right? So instead of actually syncing, which I don't know why they have this on here, maybe because it is kind of like a beginner's thing. Let's see. There it is, Louis Vuitton. Yes, cool. It's a good, really nice group. Anyways. Does save a lot of space. A lot of people, yeah, Reyes, it does save a lot of space. Honestly, a lot of people, like DJs that I've seen online, literally just bring this with them to gigs as like a backup in case their big controller doesn't work, in case something goes wrong and they're like, oh shit, like I got nothing. They always have this as like a backup, and they can, and it takes up so little space that you can legitimately put it into your backpack right next to your computer and always be able to like DJ mobily. And the fact that it actually has an 1/8-inch out, you can plug this directly into a speaker. So if I had a tiny little speaker, like a little Bluetooth speaker or something like that, that I wanted to just kind of maybe DJ at like a small party for like 20 people or do some sort of rooftop event or something like that, you literally just plug it in from right there, right into a speaker, and you got your computer, you have this thing, which literally can sit right on top of the computer, and you have your speaker, and that's your entire DJ setup. It's unbelievably unbelievably great as far as space conservation and like weight conservation. It's amazing. So the other thing that you'll, I don't know if you guys could notice this, but right here there's these buttons that essentially help you as far as cues or loops or rolls or anything like that, any effects that you have that are built into the Serato program. You can cue them on here and like play them and jump to different parts of the song, that sort of thing, with these buttons down here. This up here has 4. This has 8, which I really like. This has 4 per side. So if you notice, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's 4 what they call cue points. And then I don't know if you can tell, these little buttons right here, there's 5 of them. Those are buttons say cues, auto loops and rolls, loop, sampler, and slicer. It's just essentially different things that you can do to a song. When you cue up, when you hit the cue button, it allows you to go to a certain point in the song so you can jump into new songs in certain spaces of the new song to like make it sound more interesting or different. Or you can jump from one part of the song to another using the cue points. Auto rolls are basically like that like thing that kind of goes on, and that allows you to create rolls that are, you know, different lengths of time, like an eighth of a beat, a quarter of a beat, half a beat, full beat, 2 beats, that sort of thing. This loop does essentially what you think it does, where like if there's a break in a song that's just like a drum beat and I want to extend that, I can literally hit that loop button, hit, you know, 4 bars, boom, it'll grab that loop and it'll allow that to just spin all like for as long as I want. This sampler essentially allows you to like sample different things. So I have like an air horn, like a couple other things, and they're all queued up on these different pads. And then the slicer thing is a really cool aspect. This is a ridiculously cool aspect to this Newmark NV. And what it does is it breaks down, it's kind of cool, it breaks down the song into beats. And every pad has its own beat, okay? So it's, I don't know if you guys know any of it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's kind of how innately the beat of this song is going. There's a kick on the 1 and the 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. You got that snare on 2 and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, with that in mind, what this does is it breaks that down into 2 measures. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. And this entire little 8-pad lights up one color. And then depending upon where the beat lands, where you are in the actual beat, there's a red dot, right? And what you can do when you slice things is you can take, instead of saying like 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, you can actually jump and hit twice. It's 2 twice. So you can go 3, 4. 1, 2, 2, 4. 1, 2, 3, 3. And jump around within those 2-bar parameters. So you can make the song actually sound different in micro doses, if that makes any sense. So that's what the slicer does. Up here, I'm noticing that there is a small little box in the middle, and that's the pad mode. That allows you to jump between cues, auto loops and rolls, manual loops and samples. So it basically does 60%, I would say 50% of what this does as far as parameters and compatibility with editing songs on the fly. That's what this is right here. If you wanna look over here, jump over here, this right here is a bunch of like different effects parameters that I have. And that's the one thing that I'm a little bit kind of about, because there are literally no effects I can that are on here that I can use. So I may have to actually, I gotta figure that out. That's not a big deal.
Can you see
the OBS? Oh, of course you can.
Can you send this to me?
Send this? Oh yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. Yeah, as soon as I'm done with it. Yeah, I like this song. 4, 2, 2. I don't know if you guys can hear that. 3, 2, 3, 4. This right here, there are effects parameters to do. Here. I didn't send it, no. Here, I sent it. There it is. This is Point Point. For those of you who are interested in the song, I actually really like this song. It's like, it's kind of like chill out, but like a little bit like future bassy. It's kind of cool. There's a lot of extra stuff on that list, so sorry about that. But anyways, let me finish doing this real quick. So that's the one thing that this tiny little guy does not have, that this guy does have, as far as just parameters and little tricks and shit. So I'm gonna have less control over getting in and out of songs, I would say, on this little guy, than I would on this big new mark. But that's okay, because I'm not really interested in doing too many tricks and shit while I'm performing live. I just need to get in and out of songs. So here we go, let's move this over a little bit. I think that's it right there, that's all I'll need to do. Cool, right here are all the master volumes on this top one right here. And they coincide with, this is a master volume down here, and then this is volume for track one and track two, and that's the cue level right here. All right, there we go. We have basically this little jog wheel in the middle is kind of cool. You can legitimately jump songs right here and load them into one or two really quickly. So if I'm looking at my computer, I can like zip through the songs really quickly. Oh, that's the one I want. I want to load it on 2 inches. Bop, it's right in there really quickly. And that is kind of cool. That allows me to jump between songs easily, which I need. And thank you for those super hearts. I can see them actually going down. That's so cool. Anyways. Right here, excuse me, this allows you to, I don't know, you can probably see it, it's headphones. This headphone little thing allows you to listen to what's coming up on this track or this track, depending on, you highlight that, and then it allows you to listen before everybody else listens, or while everybody else is listening, just depending. So that's that. This right here, obviously, if you can tell, has actual faders, and it also has a left right, you know, this only has a left right transition. So basically what I'm gonna have to do, what I'm gonna have to learn how to do, is utilize, because I typically utilize faders, and here we go, when I DJ currently, I utilize faders mainly, and I'll utilize EQs. I'll have the EQ, let's say this song is fully in, right? Let's say This right track right here, the one that's all the way up, is fully in. In order to get this track right next to it involved, what I would do is I would drop the low and mid, I would put it up to about 80%, I'd introduce the song a little bit, and then I'd slowly but surely take the EQs out of the song that's currently playing and bop the new song in and put the EQs in. So I would put low and mids usually into the song as the song that is fading out is fading out, and as the new song is coming in, I'll add body to the new song. I can't do that with this guy. That is no longer I have no longer any ability to do that. So the abilities that I do have on this guy are essentially queuing up, making sure that I'm queued, that my level here is good, and then essentially utilizing this level as a way to fade in. So instead of there being individual faders, there's literally like level knobs, then there's no EQ. So I've got to make sure that whatever I'm fading out of and whatever I'm fading into, they don't overpower one another. There's some sort of equilibrium there. Otherwise, it'll sound really quirky to go from like a really big song to a really small song, or a really small song to a really big song without any EQ fades. So that'll be that. I mean, it's gonna be a very interesting endeavor to kind of figure out how to make this work as smoothly as I would like it to work. But I think it's gonna be all right. I think it's gonna be all right. But I do think that I should probably jump off real quick and just kind of get myself together. We've got a little cleaning we got to do, and I know Chelsea needs to get on here in the next hour or two, and I want her to be able to get on here and do her thing. Excuse me. So I always say this right before I leave. I appreciate you guys so much. I love you so much. I want to thank very specifically Chelsea and Diane for the super hearts on Periscope. Ryan, thanks for joining on Twitch. Anybody else on Twitch, thank you guys so much. Be sure to follow me. I'm going to be doing a lot more music-style streams in the near future, hopefully starting tonight, definitely this coming week. And I'm going to be streaming here. I'm going to be streaming on Twitch, and hopefully I'll be streaming on YouTube all at the same time. I do want to thank anybody new here to my Periscope stream or to YouTube or to Twitch. Be sure to follow me, subscribe to me. It's all I Am Rob Hazen. I also have an Instagram page as well, I Am Rob Hazen. Be sure to follow me there. I'll post some clips of the new YouTube video I'm going to be posting next week on my Instagram. So, hold on, let me see. I'm looking at myself. This is very meta. Okay, cool. I really do appreciate you guys hanging out. I'm going to be doing a lot more of this stuff. I love this. And I like this background music too. It's been a lot of fun. But I'm going to go. Thank you so much. Next time you see me, I will be jamming on this guy right here. This little dude. And you guys will hopefully be, not cringing too hard. Love the love, guys. Send it all back. Thank you. I'll see you soon. Bye. Introducing